Okay, now we will see explicit intents in action. So I'm going to create a new project for that and name it explicit intent. Again, I'm going to create it as minimum 15 API and going to use empty activity, and main activity will be main activity only. I'll name it as main activity only. Now, so in this particular application, I'm going to create one activity as my main activity, and there will be a button, and when I click on that button, it will transfer me to my next activity. And the way I do it is by using my explicit intent. So this is the layout of my main activity. I will just put a new text view here. Call it explicit intent. And increase the size to 24. Now, create a button. Next. Now, I need to give a onClick attribute to this button so that when somebody clicks on this button, something should happen. So inside this, I will put onClick and I will do something. You can name it anything you want to name, and then click on the text and press Alt Enter. That's the shortcut to generate your method in your Java file. Otherwise, you could have always done it manually too. Now my main activity is ready and the UI for my main activity is ready. All I need to do is put the code to transfer to my next activity. But for that, I need to create my second activity. So how do I do that? For that, I need to right-click on my development package, go to New, and then go to Activity, and click on empty activity and name your activity. Let's say I want to name my second activity as second. And do I want to generate the layout for that too? Yes, I want to generate the layout for that. Do I want it to be a launcher activity? No, I already have a launcher activity. Do I want it to make it a backward compatible activity also? Yeah, I do want to make it. So that's why you need to check this checkbox too, and the package name will be this, and press finish. Now, as you can see, there is a Java file, there is a XML file, and there will be an entry in the manifest file also. There you go. So whenever you create a new activity, there has to be three steps you need to take care of. First, a Java file, then an XML file, that will be a UI part, and then there should be a definition of that activity in your XML file too, that is your Android manifest file. Until unless there is no registration in your Android manifest file, your activity will not work, your application will not be able to see your activity. So now I can give any UI which I want to my activity. Let's just change the background of this. Click on your UI, click on your relative layout here, and then go to View All Properties, go to Background, and if you know the color code, then you can directly put a color code that is a hexadecimal value. Or if you don't know a color code, you can always choose this Browse button. Let me go that through again. Just click on this Browse button, select a color, and click on Add New Resources, and click on this new color value. And from here on, whichever the color suits your requirement, just select that color and press OK. And the and it will get you the and it will automatically get you the hexadecimal value. So that's how my second activity looks like now, the background. If I want to put a text view here, I can always put a text view. And I will call it, let's say, explicit intent. And let me give the ID as 36SP. Or let's just call it second activity. There you go. So my second activity is ready. That's how my second activity looks like. All I have to do is put the code to transfer to my second activity. So for that, intent I1 equals to new intent. And I need to initialize my intent. For that, as it is a explicit intent, so first is source. Source is this activity itself. And second is destination, which activity I want to transfer. That is second. So second dot class. If there would have been an another activity or any other activity I want to transfer, I will put the name of that activity. And at the end, I need to put start activity. I need to trigger the intent, and this will transfer me to my next activity. Let's just see this in action now. Run this on your emulator. So as you can see, my application is up running now. Just click on next. Then there you go. You are able to transfer to your next activity. So when you click on your back button, you will be transferred back to your previous activity, as that activity is only on the back stack, is only present on the, whenever you click on your back button, you will get transferred to your previous activity, as that was the only activity which is present in your back stack right now. And if you click again back, your application will close because there is no further activity or previous activity in your back stack now. So that was how you create an explicit intent, and how with the help of explicit intent you can transfer to the next activity. What if you want to transfer the data too? For that purpose, let me just modify my UI now. I will put a edit text here where user can put any data what he wants, and I will give this edit text ID edit1, and I will also give a hint to this so the user can identify what he needs to do. Enter your data. So I have this edit text now. So whenever user opens my application, he will be shown with this particular edit text and a button. So he can enter the data, and when he clicks on next, this data should be transferred to my second activity. And in the second activity, if I take a look at UI, this is my UI of second activity. So I need to transfer the data here, but I need a mechanism to show that data. So for that, for showing data, I need a text view here. So I will put a text view here, and I will give the ID to this, let's say result. And as of right now, it doesn't show anything, but I will put the size, text size of 30 SP. Okay, and if you want to change a color of text color, just change again, click on browse and select color from here and add new resource. That would be new color. Let's just make it red. Okay, cool. Now come back to my main activity. First thing first, I need my edit text access. So for that, edit text E1 and E1 equals to edit text. Find view by ID R dot ID dot edit one. Now I'm referring to this same edit text which I have designed here. Next thing is I need to put the data inside the intent before I actually fire it. So that's why I will put this statement here. That would be I1 dot put extra. Put extra is the method by which you can transfer the data between two activities with the help of intents, and this will save the data in an abundant class object. Bundle class object saves the data dynamically. So as soon as you close your application, your data goes away. First thing, I need a key here because bundle class saves data in the form of key and value pair. So I will put any key, let's say user. The data here, I don't want to put my own data, but I want to put whatever the user entered in my edit text. So I already have the access of edit text, that is E1. So I will put E1.getText. To string, I need to change it to string. So now I have kept my data inside my I1, that is my intent, and after that I'm firing my intent. So my data is already passed to my second activity. Now all I need is, in my second activity, I need to access that data here. But for that, before I do that, I need the access of my text view, because this is where I will be showing my data. So txt1, again txt equals to text view, and find view by id r dot id dot result. Now I'm referring to the same text view which I have in my second activity. That's the text view. Next, I need to get the access of that intent. So how do I get the access of intent? Who has called this particular activity? For that, we need to do get intent is the method. Now it will give you the access of that particular intent who has called the second activity dot get extras. Now this whole thing will return you a bundle object. So I will do it in bundle b1 equals to get intent. So now everything which you have transferred from your first activity to the second activity is now inside your b1. So all I need is to access one by one whatever the data you want to access from it. Now as of right now, in my bundle there is only one data, so I can put, and that too is a string. So b1 dot get string. If it would have been an integer, it would be get int. If it would have been any other data type, it would be accessed accordingly. So here inside this, here you will put your key, and if you remember, at that point of time I put user. So here I will put user only. And last, all I need is, I have my data back in my S1. So I need to set this S1 to my text view so that in my second activity, I can see this data. So txt1 dot set text and S1. And that's all I need to do to transfer the data. If I run this application now, so you can see there is an edit text now. I will transfer the data, let's say Lalit Singh, and press next. As you can see, the data has been transferred and the color also has been changed, as I have changed the color while I was designing it. So if I go back again, if I change anything here, the data will get changed here. So that was how I transfer the data between two activities with the help of explicit intent. Thank you.